Hello friends, welcome to CrackGate CSE, and in this series of database we are learning ER model chapter. So in this ER model chapter, till now I have discussed what are the important basics of ER diagram, ER model, relationship set, mapping, and how you can minimize the ER diagram. So there is one small variation, which is self-referential relationship set. So in this particular video we will be learning about self-referential relationship set. So before starting this video, I would like to request you all, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon so that you can get an update whenever I am uploading any such videos, right? So let's start with this particular topic. So what is self-referential relationship set? Self-referential name, the name itself suggests that if a particular entity is relating with itself, that means if a relation is taking both the entities of from same particular table, then it is known as self-referential relationship set. That means if entities of entity set E related to some other entities of same set, that is E, it is also known as recursive entity set. It can be represented as this particular diagram. Here you can see that this E1 is relating with itself, that's why both of the lines are connected to the one entity, which is E1. So this one is recursive entity set and this one is self-referential relationship set. So this is also known as unary, it is also known as unary relationship set, right? So now let's try to understand this with help of example. So in this particular self-referential relationship set also, there will be four different kind of mappings, which will be one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-one, and many-to-many. So these kind of four mappings can exist in this particular unary relationship set also. So now let's try to discuss all of these mappings one by one with the help of some example. So I took this example where employee is an entity and employee ID and employee name is the entity set, or we can say that the employee is a table and employee ID and employee name are the two attributes, and reports to is a relationship set, right, which is used to relate the supervisor and subordinate. So the first case is each supervisor can supervise many subordinates and each subordinate reports to one supervisor. That means if you consider the performer of a company, and a particular employee can handle a team of n number of employees, but all those employees, all those team members should report to one head of the team. Either it will be a team lead or it will be a manager, right? So you can see that this is the particular representation where I showed the one-to-many relationship, because there is one-to-many or many-to-one, whatever you can say, right? Both are the same thing. So these are the two attributes, this is the entity and this is the relationship set. So here I am taking two different tables, one is for this employee, one is for this reports to. So here you can see that one employee can report to, what is he saying, that one subordinate can report to one supervisor. So these are the subordinates which can report to one particular supervisor, but one supervisor can supervise many subordinates. That means a supervisor is also an employee. That means one employee can supervise many employees of the same table or a same company. So this E1 is supervising E1, E2, and this E1 is supervising E3 as well. That means one employee is managing more than one employees. Similarly, if you check from the other end, that each subordinate reports to one supervisor. So you can see that this E2 is reporting to E1, this E3 is reporting to E2, and this E4 is reporting to E2. Now if you observe one important thing, that here EID is the employee key, because it is all are different, unique, and they are uniquely able to identify the records or the tuple of the table. But here you can see that if you talk about the supervisor is not able to uniquely identify the records of the table, because here we are having repeated values, so it is not unique. But Here if you see that the subordinate, it is having unique value. That means they are not repeating. There is no redundancy in that particular attribute column. So can we say that this particular subordinate will behave as a key for reports to? Yes. So the key always be that one which is not referring to, sorry, which is not having a redundancy. So this is one to many. So here I am writing subordinate and here I am writing supervisor. So you already know the relation by this particular diagram, right? So the key will be supervisor. Now what if you want to merge that particular table? Now if there is a question that what is the minimum number of tables required, so I already told you in one of my previous video that if there is a one to many relationship, if there is a one to many relationship, in that case a particular ER diagram or the relation can be merged from many side. So here if you apply the same logic, you will be understanding that this particular can be merged from many side. And if this is the case, these both of the things will be in one table only, because we are merging the relation with the employee table or the employee entity. Then what will be the table? Employee reports to. So the table is employee reports to. There will be how much field? There will be three particular fields like employee ID, employee name and supervisor. I am not writing subordinate because subordinate is nothing but same as EID, so we can easily relate. So employee ID are E1, E2, E3 and E4, name are A, B, A and C. So you can see that the E1 cannot be supervised any because there is no such details. That means E1 would not be reporting to any others. That means that there is no supervisor for E1. So I can write it as null. For E2, which one is supervisor? E1 is supervisor. So I can write it as E1. For E3, E1 is supervisor. And for E4, E2 is supervisor. So if you consider this particular table, here what will be the key? Employee ID itself can work as a key, right? Now how many foreign keys are required? So there will be one foreign key which is supervisor, which will be referring to this particular employee ID. So minimum one RDBMS table required and one foreign key is required. So if there is one to many relationship, we can minimize it into the one RDBMS table and one foreign key if it is unary relationship set, right? Similarly, there are some other cases also where the relationship is not one to many. So let's talk about those cases as well. So in this second statement, you can see that each supervisor can supervise one subordinate. Earlier it was many, and each subordinate reports to one supervisor. So you can clearly observe that this is one to one relationship. So this is one to one relationship. The ER diagram will be like this. So this is the employee table and I am forming out the reports to table. So here it says that each supervisor can supervise one subordinate. So E1 can supervise any of these other team or other employees. So let's say E1 is supervising E2, E2 is supervising E3 and E3 is supervising E4, right? And each subordinate reports to one supervisor. That means each subordinate will report to only one supervisor. That means E2 is reporting to E1, E3 is reporting to E2 and E4 is reporting to E3. Now you can see the relationship table. In this particular relationship table, supervisor and subordinate both can be selected as the primary key or the candidate key, because both of the column values are different, they are unique and they are not null. So we can say that both of the attributes are eligible to be the candidate key. Now the next question is whether we can include this in our table. So you might have remembered that I told you that if there is one-to-one relationship, it can be mapped to any side. If there are two entities, I told you that it can be mapped to any side. That means if I talk about here, it can be mapped with employee table by considering either this or this. So let's say I am just considering this particular section and merging it in a table. Then what will be the table? The employee reports to table will be like this. Employee ID, employee name, and supervisor, because supervisor is supervising one value which is already in employee ID. That's why I am not writing this subordinate here, right? So it is E1, E2, E3, E4, name is A, B, A, C. Now you can see that the employee ID E1, no one can supervise E1 because no one is reporting to E1. E1 does not have any supervisor. That means none. E2 is having E1 as supervisor, E3 is having E2 as supervisor, and E4 is having E3 as supervisor. Now if you consider this particular table, here this value is null, but they both can act as a, this EID or this supervisor field can be treated as a candidate key, but primary key would be employee ID. So how many candidate key? Two candidate key, one is employee ID and another one is supervisor. So minimum how many tables are required? You can see that one table is required and one foreign key, that is supervisor, which is referring to the employee column of the same table. So I already told you that foreign key can be referencing into the same relationship. So minimum one table required and one foreign key. So this is how you can minimize this. But now the next thing is, if there is many to many relationship, that means if each supervisor can supervise many subordinate, that means one supervisor can supervise many subordinate and each subordinate reports to many supervisor. So now we are having a relationship which is many to many. So this employee ID is same as this, but there will be a different reports to table because one supervisor can supervise more than one subordinate. So here you can see that E1 is supervising E2 also, and E1 is supervising this E3 also, right? Similarly, each subordinate reports to many supervisor. So you can say the E3 is reporting to E1 as well, and same is reporting to E4 as well. That means there exists a many to many relationship. And if there is a many to many relationship, first of all, check for the key. Here E1 cannot be a candidate key, and supervisor cannot be a candidate key, and this subordinate cannot be a candidate key because both of them are having the redundancy. There is, they are not able to uniquely identify the table. So what will be the key for this relationship table? Key will be supervisor with subordinate. So if they both will be working as a key, right? Now the question is whether we can minimize this or not. So I already told you in one of my previous video that if the relation is M to N, that means the relation cannot be merged with any of the entity set. That means the relation has to be managed separately. And if this relation needs to be managed separately, that means that you cannot merge it with the any entity set. So here we will be requiring two tables, and if there are requirement of two tables, we will require two foreign key because we are managing this reports to table uniquely, and both will be referring to this particular table. So if you minimize it, two table and two foreign key will be required. Now let's try to minimize a ER diagram which is having self-referential relationship set, right? So this is very important question. Just go through this once, pause the video, and you can try it by your own. And in case if you are facing any difficulty, you can check the solutions later on, right? So you can pause it and check. So I hope you checked how to solve this particular answer. Now let's find out. So this is the given ER diagram, and in this given ER diagram, they are asking these three questions. That means, first, what is minimum number of tables? Second, what is the total attribute in minimized ER diagram? And what are the number of foreign keys which is required in minimized RDBMS or relational database diagram? So here you can see that, first of all, this one. Here I am having one too many because here it is an arrow. There is no arrow. Similarly, this is one too many. And you can see that this is one to one. And this is many to many. Right? So first of all, identify the relationship first. So there is no there is no total participation. So we need not worry about the participation. Right? Now, I already told you that if there is one to many, then it can be merged from many sides. So they both can form one table. Now you can see that this R3 is 1 to 1. So if it is 1 to 1, it can be mapped into one table from any side. So this can be mapped into one table, right? After that, you can see that this is 1 to many relationship. And if it is 1 to many relationship between any two entity, any two table, we can merge the relationship set with the many side. So it can be merged with this many side. So this will be one table, this will be another table combinedly, and this will be treated as a different table because it is many to many, so it needs to be managed separately. So minimum how many tables are required? You can see that minimum 3 tables are required. Now the next question is, how many attributes are required here? So here you will be requiring 2 attributes, right? And now for this, we will be requiring 3 attributes, A, B, and 1 for the key, like I explained to you earlier. 1 to many. So let me show you that. So here I am having 1 to many, and I need 3 different attributes when I am minimizing it. So similarly, I need 3 attributes here, 3 for this particular minimization, and 1 for this. So 3 plus 1, 4 for this particular table, and 2 for this particular table. So 3 plus 4. Plus 2, which is nothing but 9. So we'll be requiring 9 attributes. Now the question is, how many foreign keys are required? So 2 foreign keys for this, 1 foreign key for this, 1 foreign key for this, because this is also in the same table. So 2 plus 2 plus 1, so total 5 foreign keys are required. So this is how you can answer these kind of questions. So if you find this particular video useful, give it a thumbs up and mention your feedback or suggestion in the comment, because your likes and your comments are really motivating for us. It gives me the motivation to work more hard for you guys, right? So I'll be keep on creating such videos if you keep on supporting and keep on loving all this content, right? So if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe the channel and share it with your friends also, and ask them to subscribe the channel so that they all will be getting benefit of this free channel, right? So thank you very much for your support. And in case if you are having any doubt related to any question or any strategy, you can post that into my Facebook page or Facebook group. The links will be given in the description. You can go through the description to connect with me on Facebook. So thank you very much for watching. Keep supporting, keep learning. Have a great day.